Hey and welcome back to another Darkfall tutorial. So today we're going to be looking at the quick smoke tool, and we've used this in the past, but I pretty much glossed over it, so I'm going to go into a little bit more detail to achieve this. So the first thing we should note that I'm in cycles render, and also I'm going to change the resolution settings. I'm just going to drop it down to 720. Okay, so I've already deleted the cube and I've got rid of the lamp, so it's just my camera in the scene. With Shift A, I'm going to add in some text. And then let's just tab to go into edit mode. And let's just rotate this. So if we press R, then X, then if we press 90, then enter, just rotate this 90 degrees on the X. Now if we press numpad 1, we go to front view. So then if we hold Control, Alt, and then press 0, we can sort of align the camera to the view. Just going to grab this and center it. So now we should probably change the font. Not many people like the Blender font. I mean, I think it's okay, but everyone says it's a sin to use a Blender font, so let's get rid of it. So over to the font panel, go down to the font here, regular. Let's just open up a new font. And if you don't have any fonts, I'll leave a link in the description where you can go and download some. But this one looks good, and let's give this some geometry. Right now it's a 2D object, so let's make it 3D. So over here under geometry we can increase this extrusion, or this extrude value. As we do that, it just extrudes it out. It looks pretty good, but it's quite flat towards the edges. So what we can do is give this some bevel. If we increase the depth, give this some bevel, and then let's increase the resolution as well. Looks a lot better. Now most fonts will work fine, see how it looks okay apart from this here, but some fonts don't want to work with the extrusion and they just go all crazy. What you will have to do is either change your font or maybe do a little bit of cleanup work, which is what I have to do here. So to do that, make sure you're happy with everything before we convert this, because there's no going back, we won't be able to change things. Hit spacebar, and then if we type convert, and then select this convert to. So we want to convert to mesh, so select this one here. So now when we press tab to go into edit mode, we are actually in an edit mode like we would any other object. And I just want to get rid of this this piece here which shouldn't be here. So I'm just going to quickly do that. Press numpad 1, press 5 to go into orthographic view. Then I want to change this to face select mode. Press B. If we try and select these now, it won't work. What we need to do is to see through these. Right now it's a solid object. If we press Z or Z, we can go to wireframe mode. Now if we try and select these, maybe if I hold control and then the plus arrow, just select anything else that it's connected to. Press X, delete faces. That looks pretty good. Now we probably should save this, so control S. And let's go ahead and add some smoke. So what you can do with the smoke selected, we can go over here to the physics tab and then just give this some smoke, then Shift A, add a domain. But now Blender's made it easy, you can just quickly do that. With the smoke selected, we can press spacebar again, and this time if we type quick and select quick smoke, it's now added not just the domain cube, but it's turned this into an emitter. And it's also added the correct materials for this domain cube as well, so it saved us quite a lot of work. Now all we have to worry about is just making this look good. So jump to the first frame, then press Alt and A. We can play through this, see what it looks like. And it's not looking too good, it looks actually looks quite rubbish. First thing we can change is the lighting. You can see it's all black, which it shouldn't be black, so let's go ahead and add a lamp. If you've already got a lamp in your scene, then you can play around with it and change it if you need to. I'm going to Shift A, go to lamp, add in a sun lamp. So now if I press R to rotate, and if I press X, it's going to constrain it on the X axis. I'm just going to rotate it like this. That looks good. I also want to maybe increase the strength. And then just move this back a bit so I don't have to worry about it. So nothing's changed right now, and that's because we need to update it. Every time you make a change to the smoke or the emitter, you will need to jump back to the first frame. Then press Alt A, just to cache things in again. Now you see how it changed from black to white, that's because it was already cached in partially. So what we can do, jump back to the first frame, and just select the domain. press G and then right click just to reset it. Now if we press Alt A, it'll just update it. So now it kind of looks like a nuclear explosion type smoke, but the style I want is like a wispy, I don't know, smoky cigarette smoke type effect maybe, I don't know. So the way to make this smoke look better, with the domain selected, if we go over to the physics tab. Now this here, this resolution, increase this to maybe 64. And then if we jump back to the first frame and play this through, you can see the smoke's a lot more detailed, and also when it plays back, it's a lot slower. So we can increase these divisions even higher to make it look even nicer, depends on what sort of look you're going for. But the more we increase the divisions, the less dense the smoke's going to be. To give this some more resolution, what we can do is if we go down here, but before we give this some high resolution, we want to activate the smoke adaptive domain. And what this does is it will create a box around the smoke, so it'll be smaller than the domain. It'll just help things run faster. So for example, let's say our domain is massive. It doesn't need to be this big, but just showing you for example, Alt A, it now creates a smaller cube within this cube. Now if we activate high resolution, jump back to the first frame, press Alt A, again it's slowing down, but it's got a lot more resolution in the smoke. So you can play around with these divisions and the resolution here for the high resolution. Also play around with the strength. So play around with these values until you get something that kind of works for you. But as I mentioned before, I want a sort of wispy smoke effect. What we can do is make it disappear. We don't want it to go all the way to the top. So again, with the domain selected, go over to dissolve, select that. Now this time here, if we just jump back to the first frame, jump to the front view, the smoke will probably end around here. But if you want the smoke to continue a bit higher, we just want to increase this to maybe 6 or 7. Let's jump to the first frame, press Alt A, see how this looks now. So now it kind of fades out and ends, which is pretty good. Just stop this. Again, if you want it to end sooner, we just reduce this time. If you want it to end a bit later, just increase this time. But I think it looks good. Now, what I want to do is make the smoke come from the top of these letters. So let's jump back to the first frame. Let's select this emitter. Tab to go into edit mode. And again, we need to see it in wireframe. So if I press Z, so it doesn't look like anything's changed. But if we can see down here, it's changed to the wireframe icon. So that's the solid shader icon. This is the wireframe. So now we can press B. I want to select maybe this, these, and this. This is where the smoke's going to be emitted from. It's not going to come from anywhere else like it does right now. I also want to include some pieces, so if I press C, I'm just going to select some more of these faces here and just remove these. If you select too many, what you can do is just click the middle mouse wheel and just delete anything you don't need. So again, you can add some more down at the bottom if you want, or anywhere else you want. But now we've got this, we can go over to the object data panel. Then we want to go down to vertex groups, and if we click this plus button, it's just added a new group. Let's rename it. And then what we can do, since we've got these selected now, if we select assign, it's now assigned these faces to this group. And if we press A just to get rid of these, we can see which is selected by pressing select. So we know these are part of the group, everything else isn't. So now that's good. Tab back out of edit mode. Go over to the physics tab. And then all the way down, we've got this smoke flow advanced. And here in the vertex group, we just select this. Then select top. Jump back to the first frame, play through. So now it's doing what we want. Just press Alt A. Just stop this. What we can do, if we jump back to the camera view, we notice that the smoke's kind of coming out far too much. What we can do is reduce this surface here. We can set it to a value of 1 or even less. I'm going to set this to maybe 0.5. Now jump back to the first frame, play through again. It's looking a lot better. So let's also increase the resolution divisions. Let's see how this looks. Notice that it slowed right down. It's now only playing back at 1.4 frames per second. So if you're trying to play through this and to see how it looks, it might take a minute or so. Another thing we can do to manipulate the smoke is add in a force field. So Shift A, go to force field, and most of these work pretty well. Depends on what effect you're trying to go for. The ones I use quite often are magnetic, wind, force, and vortex. For this example, I'm going to use vortex, and then I just want to drag this up. So we can see kind of how this force field works. It's going to pull the smoke in a swirling direction and go up as well. Can change things, the fall off type and other things, to give you more of a varied effect. But for this example, I'm going to keep it quite basic and keep the strength as it is and just increase the noise. So what this will do is give this more of a noisy or more of a randomy smoke effect, more of a turbulent effect, I guess. But again, play around with the values to get something that works for you. What you can also do is animate these values. So say, for example, you're on this keyframe here, just press I, then jump into this frame, just increase this a little bit, press I, and now it's going to animate between these two values. Jump back to the first frame and now press Alt A. Let's see how it looks. So it's not looking too bad. So let's render this out and see how it looks. First thing we can do is get rid of the background, make that transparent. Next thing we need to do is, if we notice the smoke, it's looking black, we need to fix that as well. So let's go to the world settings and go to the color here. Just change this to white, make it brighter. Then render panel, all the way down. Under film, if we check transparent, now the background will be transparent. And then to fix the smoke, if you go to light paths, which is under the sampling section. And normally what we do is reduce these values to try and get a faster render time. But as you can see here, the volume is set to 0. If we set this to a minimum value of 1, the next time we render it, I'm just going to reduce the samples to save time. Then if we render it now, the smoke should be white. Now the smoke doesn't look too bad. If I press 2 on the keyboard, it's going to change to slot 2. So we can see the differences. So if we increase this volume to 4 or 5, if we see how the smoke looks now. Now this is with more volume. Press number 1, number 2. So it looks a little bit better. That's because there's more bounces in the volume. So now we have that. Let's jump back to the 3D view. I want to make a couple of adjustments. This smoke here, if we select the emitter, go back over to the physics panel again. I'm going to change this smoke color. I'm going to change it to a bluish color, like so. Again, you can change this color to whatever you want. Let's change this to so there's so many values and so many different things you can play around with to get this smoke to look different. It's all about what kind of smoke or what kind of effect you're looking for. Jump back to the first frame again, press Alt A. So when you're happy with how your smoke looks, we can go ahead and bake it. So to do that, if we select the domain cube, then all the way down here, we have smoke cache. Scroll down. And what we can do is, well, let's set the end frame. Just want to cut this in half. And we also want to make sure we set this end frame to be the same as the timeline. So we don't want to be baking in some extra smoke that we're not going to be using. So let's just reduce this as well. Then we can go ahead and bake it. So depending on how high resolution your smoke is or how long you're trying to bake things for, depends on how long it will take. As you can see, it's not that slow, but it'll take a couple of minutes. So I'm just going to pause this and come back when it's done. Okay, so now that's been baked, what we can do is play through this, see how it looks. You can either say, oh, that's amazing, or that's terrible. If it is terrible and you want to change it, so you'll probably go over here and notice that you can't change anything. But don't worry, all you have to do is unbake it. So go back down here, press free bake. This will just unbake everything you just did. So we can go back and now we can change things again. So only bake things when you're ready and you're happy with everything. If you need to go back, just unbake it, then we can go ahead and bake it again. Just going to go quickly back over to the node editor. Oh, by the way, when you go to the node editor, you're already in the smoke domain. You can increase this value here and make it darker if you want to, the smoke. I'm going to set this to maybe 7. just to make it a little bit darker, but you don't have to do that. It's entirely up to you. So if we change this over to the scene tab, then check use nodes, you'll see these nodes here. Then check backdrop as well so we can see what we're doing. Shift A, add in an output, go to viewer, connect that up as well. And then what we can do, Shift A, color mix. I'm just gonna go to input, add in an image for a background real quick. Again, you might want to take more time and maybe put this into a really cool looking scene. Actually, I don't want to mix, I just want to get rid of that. Apologize. Shift A, go to color alpha over. Plug this into the top one. There we go. There we go. And what we can do is you can convert pre-multiply and it'll make it a little bit darker and more blended. Or what you can do, just remove that and just manually set this to however much you want. I also want to increase the smoke brightness and color. Shift A, RGB curves, drop this on the smoke. It's not looking too bad. I am going to turn on the denoiser, so go to the render layers tab, then down, just check denoising. This should work as standard, but if you do need to play around with things, go ahead and do that. Let's give this another re-render. You want to render this out, go down to output, make sure you set where the video file is going to be saved to. Then down here to file type, you can render this out as a PNG image sequence if you want, or you can render this out as a movie file. Go to FFmpeg video, then choose encoding, and then for the presets, I'm going to choose H.264 in MP4 format. Seems to give me the best results. And then you can go ahead and hit animation. So make sure to play around with the values, try around different force fields, see what kind of effects you can get. If you make something cool, be sure to post a link in our Facebook group. So hopefully you enjoyed this tutorial. As always, thank you for watching and see you next time.